Hey, my loves. Oh, damn. I still have the pod on. Hey, my loves. I hope everybody is good. Happy Thursday. My weekend starts today. Taking a day off tomorrow. Hold on. Let's take this out. I'm taking a day off tomorrow because we need to go home. And then also, it is... Okay, so I'm taking a day off tomorrow, and also because we're going home tomorrow, it's school holidays. It's literally my lunch, but my lunch is almost finished. I've got about 6 minutes left. I went to go get Mpilo's report, and he's done well yet again. And you know, right now I'm not understanding something, and my anger or my confusion is a bit too late. I'm very quick to accept situations and quickly move on to make everybody else comfortable. So I'm here looking at my son's English mark, because that's the reason why he failed last year, right? At the end of the year. How was my son getting 30% and Maga 2014, it was like a whole celebration. So how was he getting 30% last year? And then this year, he's coming out with like 70s. I'm not understanding. Like, I'm failing to understand. Obviously, because it's his first year doing Afrikaans. First term, he got like a 68. This term, he got like a 47, 45, I think. 47, 45. I'm not too stressed. It's his first year doing this language. The first 3 years, 4 years. Grade 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then now he's repeating grade 4 again. He was just doing isiZulu, and he was doing okay. Now he's doing Afrikaans, and he's quickly had to learn and grasp the rules and make sure that he understands. Yes, sure, Zandi and I really do help him, but I must admit, Uzandi is doing the most. My sister is honestly doing the most there. I'm very, very grateful. I don't know what I would have done had she not been with me. Especially when it comes to helping my son out with like school stuff. So he's doing really well. He's doing really well. So now I am asking myself, Uguti, when's Akaleni last year? Because his math mark was okay. IsiZulu was okay. English, what happened? How's he getting 70s this year? All the other subjects, as per normal, as usual. He's doing quite great. So what happened? Oh, guys. And so we're late. We're halfway through the second year. Well, the second year where he's doing grade 4. You get. So it's quite upsetting. What if this was one of those situations where a teacher had a problem with a learner? Yeah, sure, I know Mpilo has tendencies to not want to work in class. I'm very grateful to this year's English teacher. Listen, Miss Kutsia, I think it was in the second week, she called me up. She's like, listen, your son is not behaving. First of all, the behavior is wrong. He's not willing to work. He's smart, but he doesn't want to do the work. He's smart, but he doesn't want to do the work. So she sat down with me and she's like, I told him, if he carries on with this, I will call you. And obviously, I know you don't want to get my calls. And so I think that the first 2 weeks, imagine you're new and already in jail, your parent is getting calls from a teacher. I don't like being called. I don't like problems. All the problems that I will be able to stomach are from the office. Anything outside of that, I don't want problems. So I sat him down and we spoke. I was like, yo, my babe, you need to pull up your socks. You need to work. You can't say mommy didn't ask me where my homework is, so I can't do my work. Mommy finished her school. Mommy did 12 years of school and did an additional 4 years of tertiary. It was 4 because she done failed something. But that is besides the point. So mommy has done her part. Now you need to do it. And also, you're not at a grade where I should be hassling and running after you and teaching you how to spell words. And hey, no. I don't know. Maybe I'm being too harsh, or maybe I'm a bit old school, because that's how things were done when I was a kid. Mama, not once has my mother ever asked me if I've done my homework, if I've studied, if I'm ready for a test. My mom didn't even know I had tests or when my tests were. So for me, being a parent now and comparing the time my mom was a parent to now when I'm a parent, scary times. I'd go to my dad with like projects of things I didn't know how to build. And then he'll show me, and then I'll just know how to do that. If it ever had to do with electricity, he taught me a negative and a positive. You click answer there, you connect the wires, and your light will come on, or the fan thingy will come on. I don't even know what these things are called, but I know how they work because my dad showed me. With maths, my dad was freaking brilliant. He'd sit me down, show me what a sum looks like, tell me the rule, and he would never ever come back to me, or I'd never be able to go back to him and be like, I still don't understand. And I wasn't a smart kid, but I worked really hard at school. If I didn't understand something during class, after school, trust me, you will find me there with my book. You will find me there with my book trying to understand the rule of this thing so that I know for in future how to do it. When I'm writing exams, tests, whatever, that I actually know. I don't have to keep referring, but I know the rule. If you know the basic, it's very hard for you to go fail it. I don't know if I'm making sense, but that's how I was as a kid. So I am now at a point where I'm not understanding what went wrong last year. How is my son still in grade 4? And now I'm looking at his marks. That once, it was just one subject. The whole year, it was just one subject. You know what? It's Kakmara's all right. Let me go back to work, because I actually do have work. And tomorrow I'm not coming in. Give me a second. Tomorrow I'm not coming in because I've taken the day off. You know, and not get up to come to work, and also because we're working from the office, I want a day off, man, where I just exist. In the afternoon we'll go home. I mean, Togo's knocking off at 5, and then I don't know if my mom would want me to pick her up. I highly doubt it, but yeah, let that be that. Anyway, I love you guys. I will see you later when I get home. We're not going to do much today because I am tired. We're going to go home. We're going to make dinner. I think we're going to just have like rice with mint. I actually want like pasta. And nice and creamy. See, now that sounds like such a great idea. Pasta and nice and creamy. I must, after work, I must go get that cheesy sauce. That is a great idea. Thank you for helping me figure out what we're going to have for dinner. I love you guys so much. If you have not subscribed, what's the reason? What's the excuse? Thank you so much to everybody that has subscribed. Thank you so much to everybody that keeps engaging with my videos, to everybody that keeps liking, leaving a comment. I really do appreciate that. I love going through comments and responding, and we have like a little back and forth there in the comment section. I like that. I do that in other people's videos because I enjoy it, you know. So please do like the video, hit the subscribe button if you haven't as yet. Yeah. Thank y'all. Okay, we are home. I've got a bone to pick with Spa and ShopRite. And my priorities when are not. Why is there no... You know that sauce that I normally use to make pasta? Why in Gekko? I went to Spa. No sauce. They just had plain cream. I went to ShopRite, they had sour cream and plain. I don't want sour cream. I want black pepper. So I just bought fresh cream and a sachet of black pepper. Because what is a girl to do at this point?
Let me.
Zandile, I think I must quickly make the pasta. Hey, Mazuz. I think I must quickly make the pasta.
They don't have to get up.
This
is like 4 episodes.
Yeah, that's like 4 hours.
Three.
Four. Okay. I got a Beyond Excellent full day. So I was like, matter of fact, it's when they give you a day off that does not come out of your leave days. And then you choose when you want it. So I was like, say no more tomorrow. Masati, you have a full day at tomorrow. Give it back to me.
I passed.
Woo! And now I'm gonna go to the city.
You know when you've got a kid and your kid and you don't even share a surname, and people from the child school keep calling every school and they call and say, hey, Mrs. And what you know, it's Miss Mahlangu, not Mrs. other surname.
Miss.
Because you know, like when people from bigger schools, each time they call, they'd be like, Mrs. other surname.
Yeah.
And I'd be like, no.
Miss Mahlangu, Namahlangu.
Guys, let me go cook. Let me not even waste your time. Let me go cook.
I just wanted y'all to see how shiny I look because I did my skincare and it's cold.
Smile.
Why do all of us smell with our top teeth? We all just have fucked up teeth. Also, you must ask your brother when I must go to the dentist. I want to fix this shit before my
Kante has birthday. He not spoke? Kante, why don't you guys speak?
My That's brother the, and I this speak
one.
About
this one.
Serious ne? Things. You are my mom.
I was about to say, this one thinks I'm her mother. Now I've got nothing to say.
My oldest brother and I only speak about education and job prospects. And there's that's about it.
They've got a 20-year gap between them. Age 19. Gap. Stop putting stuff on my bed.
It's your own hair.
Don't put it on my bed. The elastic was on my bed. Now you're taking the hair out and putting the hair on my bed.
Hair. But yeah, she said she's going to go cook. Yeah. This girl didn't even tell me she got hired. I just see her goggy legs and I'm like, where are you going at this time?
Okay, my love, so we're gonna go make pasta. As I mentioned, I didn't find the sauce that I was looking for. I went to ShopRite and to Spa, it wasn't there, so I just bought fresh cream, like an instant sauce, and then just the small black pepper thing. I don't have black pepper in this house. And motivation for the girl. Motivation, guys. See you again. Okay, let's get cooking.
Shit. Oh, let's skip the recap. Do you want it? Or are you good? Your phone, fam.
You'll be looking at your phone.
Yeah.
Use. Never. Are they charged? You must have a charge there.
One of the seasons of our fair marriage, Mart.
Good morning, everybody. Hello. Hello. I am home. We got home last night. There was so much traffic. Sorry, I want to make tea while I talk to you. Let's adjust you a little bit over there. Beba ngafu nuglala nawe. Ah, beba selenu noto wempete nangichu. Yeah, so we got home last night. We went and go look at Inyawes. So I'm just making coffee here. And then I'm gonna go brush my teeth while. Hello, my Scotty. Do you wanna come say hello to the vlog? Hello, vlog. It's a hello, vlog. It's a hello, vlog. It's a hello vlog. How funny. Yeah, basaba. Hello vlog. This is my baby. She never wants to talk to me. She's always so mean to me on the phone. Well, she's not mean. It's just she doesn't want to talk on the phone. How about Namku Lunzi Day? Diega mam cool. Mamara Sogdanix and Jay. Because me that already sent Funugul. Already in Jay. Voa. And numb the whopper on my. Baby pot, sit him to whop around. Getting ready for the sitting door. Can I say good morning?
My name is Chudela.
It's a good morning vlog.
Go on, no blog.
Mama, it's a good morning vlog.
My name is vlog.
Zan, you are so heavy.
Oh, my God, that's it. My name is Yovanda.
Nana, you are heavy now.
This is on me.
Every time I come here, I am abused. Mama, what are you saying? Look at it, glistening. It's all Vaseline. Not glowing. Hey, Mama, we are trying to control this.
Mean?
Who pega? Don't go back to the room shop, or Suiko, the room shop.
Biswe, really proud.
Yeah.
Let me show you what she's doing.
Uloganchi.
Wenzi.
Umbatheli ngubo.
Eh. I see mask.
So wa so was mbatheli ngubo.
Yeah, I see mbatheli ngubo. Marungenzi tshalo umbethi brook.
Hayi bo. Yok taste ngibani ukuthi ngibethi brook.
Now we scared. Scared.
Oh, mama, who's going to taste with the person who made this was wearing pants?
It's the ancestors.
Oh, now my ancestors, girl, they need to come answer me something. They need to first come answer me something, guys. I put on Vaseline on my skin. My skin is so dry. Because it's winter, I bought like a whole big ass Vaseline. Because now I. Yeah, what? Oh, konje when it's cool, umba. So yeah, mommy is trying to tell me again how to make this thing. It's almost every time I come home now. Get hot.
So nguye umuntu omela cheche zonke izinto.
Akashaya.
Isikhethwe indlala lapho mina lo yakazini ukuthi abantu mele badle nabezisifini.
Oh.
Kuse somnyaka emanjamani ngoba stress jam ndiki poto ngoba sizithekeleni ngakho. Hawa sapheke.
Apo mana ke umntwana lo baba?
Uba.
Apo mana ke nabo mamkhulu?
Ngikhona imbozi.
Nase mami Lodi.
Eh. Nase lekhiwe la nomyeni nomcale like side ngi. So bathi emntwaneni lo angabona bathi sihambeni siyokuthengani sishebo like so inyama
wabuya nene 3A1
inyama le boyipheka nhlaathenga amaphakethi wenyama ayi-20 nangikhawunti iphakethi la anga mhlawumbe is 1000 rand i-1 why bangathengi ikomo instead of that
mama ikomo is 15,000
zikhona zabo-10 7 or bacabanga ukuthi yokuhatshwa ngubani ngoba nokuhaba bakwazi.
These are the talks my mom chooses to have with me every single time. Like, these are the talks my mom wants to have with me every single time I'm home.
I'm out here asking my mom for plants. So I like this one. This is pretty, which is gonna give me like a little baby, and somehow it has to grow. And I don't have green fingers, but I'm gonna try so hard. Like, this is so pretty. Mama, do I look like Nepo? I mean, this looks nice, but it looks scary. Also, it doesn't look like an inside plant, because I don't want outside plants. What am I doing outside? That looks nice. Everything else I don't like. I like this one. I like this one. So I'm going to get this one. I don't like this plant. No, I don't like that one. I like this one a lot. This one is very nice. Okay, so now I'm going to show you what my mom's got. I have no idea what this is. What is this with oranges? So she's got like an orange tree. She's got, these are nuts. I don't know what nuts they are, but those are nuts. And then she's got a lemon, avo, and a little mango tree over there. All right, and then just on the other side of the yard, this is the vegetable garden. So what used to happen is in this corner of the yard, this is where their cattle kraal used to be, and so all the cows died a couple of years ago, so then they planted over it, and obviously now anything just grows here. So right now what they've got is they've got a sweet potato over there, they've got a peach tree, they've got, is it spring onion? I think it's spring onion. They got spinach, it's a little pomegranate tree. Things grow here. I think they just planted a lemon thingamajig. And they've always had pepper. They've got a couple of these, the pepper stuff. And then they've literally stopped buying tomatoes. They've literally stopped buying tomatoes. Every single couple of while, they've got a shitload of tomatoes from here. What is this? I have no idea what they're growing here. It doesn't look spinachy. I know Dad was putting in cabbage yesterday. Oh, it's over there. Hold on. Over there next to the sweet potato, he was putting in cabbages yesterday. Got that from my cousin's house. So yeah, I would like to have something like this, but unfortunately I don't have green fingers. I don't have green fingers. Let me go back in the house, since that's all I can do. Go sit my ass down. I need to go to Clicks. I forgot to bring Bilo's meds with me. Guys, I want to show you my face. The pimples! The pimples on my face since I got here. Let me show you. Oh, okay. Let's take Bonatter off. Okay, look. And all of these are like painful. Okay, these ones aren't. This one is. This one has been there since Friday. And who that? Who that? Hey loves, as always I am in a pep home. Look what they have, this is so pretty. Little table here for that weird area that I work out in front of. I don't even know how much this is. This is very, very nice. I like it. Can't be a desk, can it? Can't be a desk. So yeah, we're at the mall. We came to get Bilo's meds, and then we're gonna go home, and then I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna go back to my house now. I have been here for ever and a day. Vlogger. Hey vlog. I'm sorry that my camera is it's freaky wicked. We're in a shop. Mommy's getting me a jacket. I'm getting a jacket for, can you see? 220 rand. And then mommy's looking for skirts. Hey my loves, I'm on my way back. It's now almost 2:22. I'm tired, I'm peopled out, back to my house. Yes, my back seat is full. It's not just the back seat and the boots. Guningi, guningi my dears.
means if I'm being, what's the word? Generous. Probably have like 30 minutes of footage, and I'll still put it out. Even if it's less than 30 minutes, I'll still put it out. Let me go home. It's been a nice weekend. It's been fun. But now I'm peopled out. Yeah?
Are you making an outro?
We'll make an outro, but when you're comparing my tone and yours, Uputi was like, no, but when I said you must remember that Upale.
He says this to me as he's not just brown, my brother is dark skin.
He's very dark.
He's saying that to me, I'm just like,
yeah. The printer had run out of melanin. By the time Zandi was born, the printer was out of melanin, and that was that. No, but you look fine, my babe. You don't look fine.